installing Ubuntu, you'll need two things, a USB and a computer. The latest release can be downloaded from Ubuntu.com. Pro tip, get the torrent, it'll download hella fast. Stick it in. Use the USB Creator utility to make a bootable image. The website has a picture tutorial, so I won't really cover what to click. The USB should blink like crazy. To boot to the USB, you'll need to hit one of the F keys to change boot priority. I use Ubuntu because it's free. I feel more productive with it. Better security. I think it looks cool. You can customize anything and everything, except for, like the proprietary NVIDIA driver. I like my apps being up to date. The Cloud Sync is great. Did I say it doesn't get viruses? Moving on. The website has pictures on how to click next through this, but I'm doing something different. I'm putting the operating system on one partition and keeping my home folder on a different partition so that I can swap out operating systems easily. Fresh install. Now to get my faves. Chrome, Steam, Hewin, GIMP, KeyPass, Audacity, OpenShot, Sound Converter, CAD. I totally read the terms of service. Oh, hey. Linux is really stable, and rather than freezing, usually the offending app will just gray out. Unless it's Compiz or X11. Check for any proprietary drivers that may be available, especially if you have a graphics or wireless card. Okay, this one's really important. Get the restricted extras. You'll need it to play back proprietary formats. Alright, now for making panoramas. First, you gotta get out there and collect some pictures. Notice how about a third overlaps. This will make stitching easier. Auto Pano Sift is amazing, but you need to change the default parameters. Set the program to Auto Pano Complete and pass it the arguments -p, %p, -o, %o, %i. -p is to tell Auto Pano the number of control points to look for, and %p is the number you set in the preferences. Same thing for O, but in regards to the output file. I doesn't get an argument because it hands the pictures to AutoPano. Now make the preview look like you want by straightening it, changing the field of view, cropping. Before you can output the file, you need to save the project. It will make intermediate files before it brings them all together. If you save it as a TIFF, it'll save them into separate layers for better editing later. That's pretty close. It'll generate a lot of control points for you quickly, and by reviewing the image you know where you need to inspect closer for perfection. I find these results acceptable. There are an absurd number of projections Hewin has. The comes down to the fact it's impossible to map a 3D sphere to a 2D plane accurately. So have a look-see at a few and decide what's best for you. Again, AutoPano has done a better job than I could have, faster. Ubuntu does have its drawbacks. For instance, here in Steam, only 39 of my 161 purchases will run on Linux, and most of them run at a lower frame rate than you'll experience on Windows. Also, the video editors aren't the best. They tend to crash a lot.